Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of CodeIgniter on a Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how you can easily create a simple CodeIgniter project and how to run that on our browser. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee this video is going to be very interesting, and if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. So do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues, you can always comment on our comment sessions. I'll always there to help you. And I'm also on Instagram now, so there also you can ask all of your doubts. I'll definitely try to help you. So now to install CodeIgniter and to create a CodeIgniter project, you will basically need three things. One is a composer. Next thing is you need to have PHP installed on your system. And the third thing that you will need is Visual Studio Code. So Visual Studio Code is what we are going to use as a text editor, and we'll need PHP, and we'll also need a composer. So again, on my previous videos, I have showed you how to install VAMP server. So you need to, you know, go to this URL and you need to download the VAMP server, and within VAMP server we have all these different versions of PHP. So you can just follow that video to install VAMP server. Once you have VAMP server, next you can jump on to download Visual Studio Code. Just simply type Visual Studio Code and just go to their official site and download Visual Studio Code for our Windows. Next thing that you will need is Composer. Just simply type Composer download and you will see this getcomposer.org. Just go to their official site and you will see Composer setup.exe over here. So you need to click on this link and that's going to start downloading your composer. So both our composer and Visual Studio Code are directly downloaded. So both this link, getcomposer.org along with Visual Studio Code and VAMP server, so all those links I'm going to provide right in our description. So you can get all these different links from our description. So once you download all these different products, let's go to your download directory and you can see our XAMPP, then Visual Studio Code, Composer, everything is downloaded. It's time to install. Let's first install our Visual Studio Code. Just accept the license agreement. Click on next, next, select all the options, next, and install. So it's going to start installing our Visual Studio Code. So our Visual Studio Code is rightly installed. Click on finish. So that should be launching our Visual Studio Code. I'll close this for the time being. So next thing is you need to have PHP installed on your system. So on my previous videos, I have installed VAMP server. So if you go to your C drive, once you have VAMP server, you will see we have a VAMP64 folder, and within that we have a bin folder, and there you will see a PHP folder. So just go inside that PHP folder. And you will see we are already having all these different versions of PHP. So from that, this is the latest one, which is PHP 8.3.6. So I'm going to point to this folder. So here, if you scroll down, you will see php.exe lying over here. So this path is what we need to point to Composer. If you are using some other server, like if you are using XAMPP, that also totally fine. So in case of XAMPP, then to go inside XAMPP and you'll see there is a PHP folder. So there also you'll see php.exe lying over there. So this path is what you need to point to Composer if you want to use XAMPP. All right. So I'm going to use VAMP. So let's go to this Composer setup. Double click on it. Click on install for all users. It'll ask if I administrative privileges. Click on yes, and here just simply click on next. So here it is showing all that different php.exe files that are available. Remember, I have showed you this path, so latest version of php 8.3.6. you can also use XAMPP, so in that case you need to select XAMPP. All right, so I'm going to use VAMP latest one, which is 8.3.6, so I'm going to select that, and I'm going to also check this add PHP to your path. So that's going to automatically set our PHP path to our environment variable, so we don't need to do anything manually. Just click on next after that. So that's going to quickly install our a composer, so ready to be installed. Click on install and there you go. It is rightly done. Just simply click on next. So our composer is rightly installed. Click on finish. So now that we have everything, it's time to create our CodeIgniter. Just right click and create a new folder on our desktop, and let's name this file as CodeIgniter dash workspace. Just go inside that folder. Here we are going to create a CodeIgniter project. So just click on this address bar and type cmd to open our command prompt right at this location. And now we need to run one script. So let's go to browser and let's go to CodeIgniter official site. Search with CodeIgniter 4. Let's click on the first link to go to the official site of CodeIgniter. So here you need to click on installation. Scroll down, you'll see all these different versions, but we are installing Composer installation. So I'll click on Composer installation, and here is the script: Composer, create project, CodeIgniter 4, app starter, project root. So that is what we need to run. So this link also I'm going to provide on our description. So you need to copy this link and go to your, you can minimize your browser and go to this location where we have created the folder, right click and just hit enter. So it's going to start fetching all the files from internet, and it's going to install our CodeIgniter and going to create CodeIgniter project over here. So you can see it is rightly started doing that. You need to have active internet connection so that it can fetch all the files and can install it. So it will take some time. By the time it gets installed, I'll request you please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel along with Geeky Script vlogging channel. So that's going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. And let's wait for some time over here. And there you go. You can see it is rightly done. So if you go to this CodeIgniter workspace folder, you can see that our project root folder is rightly created. So if you go inside that folder, you can see all files and folders over here. So our app basically gets created over here. So let's go inside this folder. So cd project dash root, hit enter. So we are inside our project root folder. Now just simply type code dot and hit enter. So that's going to trigger Visual Studio Code by opening this project root folder that you have created. And always click on this I trust the authors and all. So you can expand this app, you can expand any of this folder. Let's expand controller, and you'll see base controller over here. Then we also have a home.php. Let's also expand our models. So models is empty right now, but you can expand view, so that view is having welcome message.php file over here. So when we are going to render this project on our browser, so this file you'll be able to see on our browser. So let's quickly render that. Just go to terminal and click on new terminal, and let's type php spark serve. That's all, hit enter. So immediately you'll be able to see that our CodeIgniter project is actually started running on the server, this path. Just press control on your keyboard and click on this link, and it's going to show you this, whatever there on this file, this welcome message.php, it's going to render that on our browser localhost 8080. So if you are removing all these different stuff from here, so I'll go to the body tag and I'm going to remove everything that are there within body tag. So till here I'll going to select and click on delete, and I'm going to create just a simple h1 tag, and within h1 tag I'm going to write hello world. So close that h1 tag, and if I just save this file, and if I go to browser and just simply click on refresh, it's going to see that everything is completely wiped out and it is only showing hello world on our browser. So whatever we have written, so that only going to render, and this way you can start working on your CodeIgniter project on on your Windows operating system, and in this way you can start working on your CodeIgniter project. So that is basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel along with Geeky Script blogging channel. That is going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. So that is basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.